It begins. I'm loading up the Dico trailer, with materials, tools, camping gear, whatever I'm going to need. Some of it I'll carry in the van for the Colorado trip. On the Colorado trip, I will be removing the tops of two different trailers in two different cities and replacing paneling. First one being a 59 Forester in Steamboat Springs, where I will remove the entire top, the front and the rear, to replace some paneling and also to replace the rear sheet of metal outside skin, which I of course had made, and you saw that in the video just recently, at Hemet Valley RV, where they ship. And you know, I bet a lot of you people think that when I talk about Harbor Freight, Hemet Valley RV, Vintage Trailer Supply, other places like that, Ganall Lumber, I'll bet you think that I get paid by these people. Nope, not a penny. And you notice that there's no advertising on any of my videos. So, you wonder how I make my money. Well, I don't make a lot restoring trailers, that's for sure. The Shasta I made $2,200 on, and it took a year and a half. And that doesn't include the gas, which I made probably 400 trips for parts. And I'm not exaggerating. So the way I make my money is through my website, donations. There's a button on my website, www.cannedhamtrailers.com. So if you feel like I've, you know, helped you in some way, saved you some money or some time, go there and make a donation. I'd really appreciate it. Helps me buy cameras, which this one's in need of being replaced again. These cheap $300 cameras are no good. I want a $1,000 camera. That's going to take a lot of donations, so please help out if you like my videos. And from now on, I'm not going to do any more complete restores. From now on, I will be zeroing in on specific jobs involved with restoring your trailer. Jobs that are peculiar to just about all vintage trailers. So it doesn't matter what kind you have. Anyway, yep, I'm packing. Right there, you're looking at over $600 worth of materials right there. That little stack. You got a 4-inch stack of birch paneling. That's $400. And then you've got $200 worth of pine and common wood. Common wood is more expensive because it doesn't bend as easily, and you know, with moisture and sun and heat and things like that. So there's $600 worth, and I've picked up everything else. I just have to load it. I've got $100 in putty tape alone. So anyway, we're gonna load up, and I'm gonna get out of here in the next 2 days. We'll see you then. Well, I'm about 110 miles into the trip. It's 7 o'clock in the morning, and it was still dark when I left, Saturday morning. And I pulled into Denny's, luckily, because look what I found. I was hungry. And I think it's because this is all loose. I'll screw that all back together. So I needed something to do for an hour until this place opens up. They're not going to be open for an hour. So I guess I'll get the tools out, fix that fender, because I think that may be what caused it. Tread came off. And I got quite a load, but and these tires are, they had good tread on them, but they are old. You know, they're like 4 years old, I think. 3 or 4 years old. Can't remember. So, guess I'm gonna get a new set of tires here. I'm gonna go ahead and change the other one too. I don't wanna take any chances. It's a long trip I'm gonna be on, so I'm gonna go ahead and make sure that fender isn't rocking around. I really do think that that's what caused it. You can see right there, there's, if I get out of the shadow, there's where it rubbed. And I believe that's what caused the problem, is the fender rubbing on the tire. So here we go, we'll get some tools out and fix that. This place opens up at 8, it's 7 right now. So here we are, getting new tires on the trailer. I really should have just done this before I left. They look good, but one of them, this one here, was, I noticed it's, you know, cracked. So probably should have just done it right from the get-go, but I'm glad it happened here instead of out in the middle of nowhere. Although I do have a spare, but, you know, if it had blown up, that could have been messier. Luckily, just the tread came off and it was down to the steel. And I happened to get off the freeway because I was hungry and saw Denny's here on Main Street in Hesperia, so here I am. Anyway, onward and upward towards Colorado. Here we go, new tires. Tom back on the road. Barstow's up ahead. I'm just going out of range of the Keller Peak repeater. It's starting to get fuzzy. I did talk to some people. And while I was waiting for the tire store to open up, there's a speaker. And I told them I was going to Colorado. I was waiting for the tire store to open up and all that. And they all came back and said, "Oh, be careful. Colorado's on fire." Yeah, I know all about it. Everybody knows all about it. But they were just being friendly, trying to give me some advice, and I told them where I was going, and that where I'm going isn't on fire. Colorado Springs is on fire. But I'm going to Steamboat Springs. It's not on fire. So, Barstow just up ahead. I think I'm going to stop at the state line, spend the night. I don't know. See how far I get and how hot it is and all that. Boy, these people join it. Look at how these people drive. Jeez. These are all the displaced Californians that ended up in Nevada, in Las Vegas. Now they wish they hadn't left. Anyway, yep, here we go. On our way. Got the new tires. We're all set. It's a little after 2, and there's an accident about a half a mile up. I've been stuck in this stuff for the last half hour in the middle of Vegas. And what the truckers say, it's down to one lane. The accident is just before Charleston, and I think I'm about 3/4 of a mile from Charleston. Turned off the AC and opened up the windows. You can see how this is, how this has been moving for the last half hour. Maybe, about the last half hour, I guess. I'd have got off, but I don't know my way around Vegas. I'd have got off and gone around this stuff, but I don't know my way around here. Well, I'm in Mesquite. Oh, that accident was terrible. There was 8 cars and 2 motorcycles involved. And I didn't even want to get the camera on it. It was a mess. Took about an hour to get through it. And I was only a mile and a quarter away from it when it happened. And from what I hear, accidents happen there all the time at the 15 and the Charleston exit. Sometimes twice a day, I don't know why. But yeah, here I am at a very elite motel. It's cooling down to about 100 now. I don't know what it was earlier, but it feels like 100 now. Maybe it's only 96. But yeah, all the eliteness, your average dump. I even talked them down on price. So, I couldn't camp out tonight anywhere around here within 100 miles. It's just too hot. There's the Dico with the new tires. One of the accident victims was a van towing a small U-Haul about the size of my Dico. Missed it by a mile, a quarter, could have been me, so I was lucky. Look at this, it's pool's empty, I guess. It's not hot enough for him to fill it up yet. Isn't that weird? Nice. Oh, there's no way to fill it up. It's all cracked and stuff. Yeah, this is total eliteness here. So as the sun sets in Mesquite, Nevada, which is basically right at state line, we're about tomorrow morning, within 15 minutes, I'll be in Arizona for a little bit and then Utah. And I'm going to try and cross the state of Utah tomorrow and get into Colorado and get up into some higher country where it's cooler. This is hot. This is just unbearable. I could never live here. Never. So, good thing the air conditioning works good in the van. Well, I'm sitting in the motel in Mesquite watching TV and talking to Fred on the computer on Skype. That's a little dippy. What a day. And it's just too hot out there to camp out. I don't think you can camp out anywhere within 100 miles of here. It's just too damn hot. So tomorrow we're going to try and get all the way through Utah and into Colorado. I decided to take the southern route because it was just going to cost too much and take too much time to go the other way. So I decided to come this way. Tomorrow it's up 15. And until I hit 70, turn right on 70. I take that until I get to, I don't know, I think it's 132 or something. Turns left and goes up to Steamboat Springs. So we get through Utah tomorrow and spend the night somewhere, camp down. I hope so. But it's been a heck of a day with that wreck and everything else. Tires falling apart. Boy, I'm having to change motels because the last motel was just crappier than this one. This one's $50. I hate spending money like that.